When the new 5 Series BMW arrived back in the spring of 1996, it met with universal acclaim. It set new standards for its competitors in virtually every respect. Yet all the enthusiast wanted to know was when the M5 version would arrive. And the answer was not what they wanted to hear. There wasn't going to be one. BMW decreed that the 540 with 286 horsepower and a 0-60 time of 6.2 seconds was quite fast enough. Indeed, the BMW boss at that time stated that the 540 had reached the physical limit of acceleration. But, of course, he was wrong. Just 18 months after the 5 Series launch, the 370 horsepower version of the supercharged 4-litre Jaguar XJR arrived and wafted to 60 in just under 6 seconds. Although the ride quality is excellent even on this old airfield surface, the handling isn't exactly pin sharp and nor is the feedback through the steering. But then this is an English gentleman's car. You're not supposed to switch off the traction control and drive like a hooligan. So, here goes. But it wasn't just the British who upset the BMW apple cart, because 6 months later, their great German rivals Mercedes came out with the E55, the ultimate E-Class, created by their tuning specialists, AMG. The normally aspirated 5.4-litre V8 only has 354 horsepower, but it's lighter than the Jag and it's got more torque, so it's faster from 0 to 60 by almost half a second. A slightly firmer ride and more road noise make the Merc less comfortable than the Jag, but it also makes it a better handling car. We now have not only traction control, but the very latest in driver aids, automatic skid control, or ESP in Mercedes' case. That's the individual wheel braking that helps counteract any understeer or oversteer. And even when it's switched off, the Mercedes still keeps its traction control, but only at speeds under 50 miles an hour. All of a sudden, the 540 wasn't quite top dog in the executive car park. Eclipsed by both Jaguar and Mercedes, pressure for a new M5 increased, and the reply wasn't long coming. Like its predecessor, the new M5 has few external features to distinguish it from the rest of the 5 Series. It's a classic wolf in sheep's clothing, with little to give away the power that lurks beneath. Yes, it's got a more aggressive front spoiler, more aerodynamic door mirrors, and a tiny spoiler on the boot lid. But it's only really the 18-inch double-spoke chrome shadow wheels, the four stainless steel tailpipes, and yes, this little badge that really give the game away. with a 5-litre V8 pushing out 400 horsepower, the BMW leaps back to the front of the pack, threatening to crash to 60 in just 5 seconds, with the sort of high-tech engineering you'd expect from its motorsport breeding. It's a car for the new millennium, when BMW return to the Grand Prix scene. Indeed, the M5 has the most technically advanced road car engine in the world, and like a racing engine, it needs to be warmed up gently. Warning lights suggest changing gear below 4,500 revs until the engine is up to temperature, and even then a 6,500 warning remains before the 7,000 limit is reached. Complete with a slick 6-speed manual gearbox as standard, you get all this for a fiver under £60,000. Just over 500 less than the Merc, but 9 grand more than the Jag. BMW's stability control system is called DSC. And like the Mercs, it has an uncanny ability to try and help the clumsiest of drivers from getting himself into trouble. You can steer viciously, and you can feel the brakes coming on individually as the car tries to slide. The car's sensors detect the problem, they take the power away from the engine, and they actually put the brakes on the wheels. It's absolutely incredible what these modern systems can do. Of course, in the end, when given an empty airfield, even in these appalling conditions, you do have to switch it off just to have a little bit more fun. This car is so beautifully balanced, it's like putty in my hands. You can't stop the rock, can't stop the rock, you can't stop the rock, can't stop the rock. The threat from Jaguar and Mercedes has been washed aside, even when I demand the impossible. The 360-degree spin is easily controlled. This car really does take you back to the future. Indeed, it's so much fun. I'm going to go back to the beginning of the programme and do it all over again.